I was hosting carne asada last weekend. A barbecue. And we had 2 dozen tortillas left, but very little carne, meat. Then my brother shows up with another dozen tortillas. I told him that was no help at all. The carne was currently my limiting reagent. No joke. He called me a nerd for using chemistry terms while cooking. He wasn't wrong. This is Real Chem. Let's take that exact same idea from the carne asada, that essential components can serve to limit a reaction. We will pay this out with sodium phosphate as the product. No es la carne. These principles are the same. We just have to keep an eye on the details. Vamos a mirar juntos. Let's explore. Consider the reaction that occurs when a solution of sodium hydroxide is added to a solution of phosphoric acid. The balanced chemical reaction is phosphoric acid plus 3 sodium hydroxides goes to sodium phosphate and 3 waters. Let's begin by considering what this looks like at the particulate level. Phosphoric acid is a weak acid. So in a solution, the protons that make this molecule an acid, shown in red, remain attached to the molecule. These species are floating in a large amount of water. Sodium hydroxide is a strong base, so the sodium and the hydroxide ions dissociate from one another and float freely in the water. From the balanced reaction, it takes 3 sodium hydroxides to react with 1 phosphoric acid. In this acid-base reaction, protons are transferred from phosphoric acid to hydroxide ion. The products are sodium phosphate plus water. Let's simplify this a bit to make it easier to see what is happening. Although the reaction produces water, this is an aqueous solution, and we aren't showing the huge number of water molecules in the solution, so we won't show these water molecules formed from the reaction. The sodium ions are important for keeping the solution electrically neutral, but they don't directly participate in the reaction. For this reason, they're often called spectator ions. Like spectators at a sports game, they're just watching the action from the sidelines. This focuses our attention on the reacting species. We can use a particulate representation to make this even easier to visualize, replacing the reacting species with symbols. Let's perform a titration, where we slowly add the base to the acid. As we start to add base, it reacts with acid to form a product. At some point, we have added just enough base to react with all the acid. We call this the equivalence point. If we continue to add base, the added base has no acid to react with and remains in the solution. We can connect this to the idea of limiting reagents. Before the equivalence point, the amount of base is less than what is needed to react with all the acid. The base is the limiting reagent because it limits the amount of product that is formed. We can also say that the acid is an excess reagent because there is more of it present than is needed to react with the base. At the equivalence point, we have the exact amount of base needed to react with the acid. There is no limiting or excess reagent. Past the equivalence point, we have excess base. The acid becomes the limiting reagent because the amount of acid is limiting the amount of product that is formed. In chemical reactions, it's often one reagent that limits the amount of product that can be formed, the limiting reagent. A similar situation arises when making a carne asada. It doesn't help to have more tortillas than carne. One of these ingredients will end up limiting the amount of tacos you can serve to your friends, and someone may end up feeling hangry. Vamos a explorar. Y no te olvides tener fun.